Okay, here in this video, we are going to consider some special cases while using the ones complement, right? So here we can see the special cases when using the ones complement for subtraction. When we perform the binary subtraction using ones or twos complement, make sure that we take enough bit positions to store the results. Let me make it clear. For example, suppose we got two numbers, -9 and -8. We know that the result will be -17, right? So the number 17, if you check the binary of 17, it can be seen that we cannot represent 17 using the 4-digit binary positions. So it is necessary that, so we know that the result we cannot accommodate in 4-digit binary positions. So it is advised that for the numbers -9, for the numbers -8, we have to take extra bit positions. Let's see how we are proceeding with these type of cases in the next slide. Okay, here I am taking the same example. We have two numbers -9 and -8. The binary representation of -9 and -8 you can see on the screen. So what we have to do, we have to find the ones complement of the negative numbers. Here, what you can see, I have taken one extra bit. Normally we take, in the case of other examples, you might have noticed, we were taking only sign digit plus 4 bit positions. Here you can see that we are taking 1 bit for the sign plus 5 digit positions. It is because we know that the result is 17. In order to accommodate the number 17 in the binary form, we need a minimum 5 bit positions or 5 digits. That is why I am taking total 6 bit positions, 1 plus 5 bit positions. One bit is for the sign. Okay, so here coming to the steps. After finding the ones complement, what we do? After finding the ones complement, we add these complements. So when we add these complements, in between we are getting a carry. That carry is added to the least significant bit. Then we are getting an intermediate result, and then we find the ones complement of the intermediate result. The ones complement of the intermediate result is equal to our desired result. That is what you are seeing on the screen. Okay. Okay. Here we got another example. We have two numbers, -19 and -14. First, have a look at the binary representation of -19 and -14. So the result we are getting, we know that when we do the calculation in the manual way, we know that the result is -33. So the result is -33, and we can see that the number 33, in order to represent the number 33 in binary form, we need some extra bit positions. In the case of 14, we need only 4 digits. In the case of 19, we need only 5 digits. But when it comes to 33, we need some extra bit positions. So here you can see that for 19, I have taken 7 bit positions. And 14 also I have taken 7 bit position. The reason is that In order to store the result minus 33, we need 7-bit position. So it is very important that we need to consider the result when we choose the bit positions, right? So here we are provided with the two numbers minus 19 and minus 14. So we are finding the ones complement of minus 19 and minus 14. That is what you are seeing on the screen now. After finding the complements, what we do? We add these complements. Okay? When you add a complement, the carry you are getting associated with the digit just before the sign is added to the least significant bit. Okay, so that is what you are seeing. I am adding one to the one to the result of that one's complement. That is the carry we got from the calculation. Then we are getting an intermediate result. And if you find the ones complement of the intermediate result, we are getting that our desired result. Here in this case, it is minus 33. Okay?